My dear Alma, we are a couple of days away from meeting you and we're very excited. But also, right when we thought this war couldn't get any more apocalyptical, the West Coast is burning.
There's bushfires all across California. The skies have turned red. It's been pollution everywhere.
Can't see the sun or the clouds for a week now. The air has been
just
like been this, kind
like
of reddish.
Hazy.
Very, very apocalyptical. And the thing is, like, you know, everybody's so concerned about this pandemic, which is concerning, but for us, this is just the beginning of something bigger because, you know, with global warming, which is causing all these fires, with the glaciers melting, with so many bacteria coming out, like, we don't know what's gonna happen. So it's a bit concerning because we don't know what kind of world you're gonna live in.
If I was you, darling, I'd just stay in there as long as I could.
Maybe just, you are.
I would not. I'd refuse to come out. Go on strike. Corona strike.
Don't take too long, though.
Don't take too long. We love you.
Love you.
See you in a couple of days in person. See you in a couple of days in person.
So today is Tuesday, September 15. It's around 5 p.m. And for the last couple of hours, I've been having mild contractions. They're very regular, every 10 minutes. But yay, that means we're gonna get to meet Alma very soon. We're so excited.
Full of power, full of strength. And I'm sending so much love to Pao, Jamie, Alma, and the whole team to bring our new community member into the world.
Almasita, mijalinda, we are so grateful for you, our born.
It's time, yeah! Wishing you a safe journey to Earth, Alma. We are so excited to see you. Got the candles lit, thinking of you, Pao, thinking of you, Jamie.
For Alma. I can't believe you're finally coming out. I probably will be asleep by the time you come out, but I can't wait to meet you.
Llegó el momento, Alma, por ti, para que tu entrada al mundo sea bella y que tu vida sea bella.
You ready to go? Let's do it. Got an escort of boys escorting you to the car. Beautiful night to have a baby. You alright? You need a hand? You good. You good. You good. Beautiful night to have a baby. Such a beautiful night.
It is one of the most beautiful nights we've had. It's nice and chilly. Thank you, Alma, for not coming in this
way. Nice and cool tonight. Oh,
I am confident. I am happy. I am safe. I see my baby gently turning and moving down the birth path.
Are you feeling any cramping? My dear Alma, welcome to the planet Earth. You made your big entrance on Wednesday, September 16th, 2020 at 9:45 a.m. and our lives will never be the same. It still feels very surreal to have birthed such a perfect little human. Every minute that passes by, we fall more and more in love with you. I now finally understand the depth of love a mother experiences when having a child. It's infinite, it's pure, profound.
So the house is a mess. Pal's not feeling so great, so, and she's been told she's not allowed to walk upstairs, so we're sleeping on the couch.
We're squatting in the living room. Show them our little happy room.
As you can see, the house is a disaster.
Where is the grandmothers when we leave them?
Yeah, it's strange not having any family here and having corona, so we don't really have anyone can come into the house because we're quarantining.
Just leaves the three of us,
which is very beautiful, but puts a little bit more strain on us.
Definitely.
But Mummy's well, Alma's well, and Daddy's gonna be pretty sleepless.
Dear Alma, here you are.
We're a baby.
So this is you. This is beautiful you. We've been enjoying you, having you home. We're a very, very happy family. And I guess we should just go straight to the point, because I think Alma and our audience are curious to know how it was birth, no? What do you think?
Yeah, birth was not quite what we were expecting.
No. So it was very intense. And I know that in hypnobirthing, you're supposed to change the wording. Instead of pain, you're supposed to say, I don't know, intense primal pressure or intense. No. It was the most painful thing I've ever experienced in my life. I'm not going to lie. It was the most painful thing I've ever experienced. The most intense experience I've ever had in my life. Like, I thought I was good with pain because I've had to deal with a hip dysplasia and multiple operations during my life, and doctors have told me that I have a high pain tolerance. Yeah, no, this is a whole other level of pain. It's not even called pain. It's so painful, it doesn't even exist a word. I'm sorry, hypnobirthing people. It was like beyond anything.
It's like, for me, it was an incredible experience. I mean, I've been now witness to two births, my two daughters. First was a hospital experience where it was like traditional lying in bed. This, me hopping to the water, I could like feel the raw power. I could feel the stomach rolling down and pushing and the waves or the contractions. I could feel the raw energy and how much energy was taking out of her. And I already knew that Paola was probably going to be vocal, but what came out of her was just primal. It was like this noise, it was like, it vibrated and shook everyone in the room. It was like this gut-wrenching mm-hmm. prime, something I've never experienced before, where she was grabbing,
I was holding him really, 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 really hard, and I didn't even realize, because at that moment you don't realize, like, I didn't even realize I was holding him so hard, but I was like holding into my dear life, into Jamie, just to get all this strength. She was crowning, which means her head was coming out, but it was coming in and out for 45 minutes. And I was pushing, like, you only push when you feel like you have to push. So, but I was pushing and pushing and pushing. And there was a moment when they said that when you give up, it's right before when it's going to happen. I remember I had this cry because I was pushing for 45 minutes. And I said, I don't know if I have more strength to keep pushing because I have exhausted the 19 hours before. You know, I was crying out of thinking, like, I don't think I have the energy. And so in the end, Tiffany asked me if it was okay. She did a little cut, which is called an episiotomy. And I said, yes, please go ahead, whatever helps.
and off she came into this world in a natural way.
That big head of hers, that big head of hers was not coming out. I mean, it was just a whole, listen, it was a strange experience. All of us had to wear a mask except for Paola, sitting in the water for 3 hours wearing a mask.
With a mask.
Your daughter seeing your face for the first time wearing a mask. I would say it was one of the most amazing experiences of my life. The team that we had, Cam and Siri, were amazing.
Siri, Tiffany.
Pure births
were amazing. The nurses are pure births.
Everyone's super kind.
Yeah.
But once the cut was done, you know, we had a baby. She came out. Super quick. She came out. She was crying. We found out she had lungs on her straight away.
She's got a good voice. She came out healthy, big. They said she's a big, large baby. My fear was that she was going to have Jamie's head and shoulders, which she does. That's why she almost couldn't come out, but she did. And the thing is, like, yes, it was intense. Yes, it was painful. There was a moment when I thought, oh, now I understand, and I can relate why so many women decide to have an epidural. Like, I get it. Like, the pain is so intense that maybe it's not meant for everyone. It should be meant for everyone, but maybe it's not. A moment it clicked. But if I had the option to do it again, I'll do it exactly the same way. Because in the end, yeah, the pain is intense, but it goes away. And it was worth it because the outcome of doing it naturally without, you know, any drugs, it's beautiful because she bonded right away, she latched right away, the oxytocin kicking right away, the connection we had with her was like instant, like the whole post bonding with the baby, it's been amazing. And then you look at her, and when you see her smile, you just think it was all worth it.
I saw you struggling. Like, I saw your...
My muscles are struggling.
Shaking because you're like... And I was like, I wonder how much more he could do this. And I was like, I wonder if there's another position I can tell her to go in to give him a break. No, I'm not going to say anything.
Because
you guys used each other's body, like that push and that pull. It was really beautiful.
Yeah. All right. We'll feed you in 1 second. I do this. This is my job. And then Mum's got the next job of the feeding. I can give you a pretend boob for half a second. Ready? Yeah, pretend boob. This is a trick our lactation consultant taught me, and it's a lifesaver.
It is. She loves it.
My precious little girl, what a journey we have had for the past 9 months. Your father and I completely isolated ourselves to the world so that the pandemic wouldn't touch you, so that we could protect you from this invisible enemy. I find myself staring at you constantly, making sure you're happy and safe. I guess it's a feeling I'll not carry with me for the rest of my life. You came into this crazy world to remind us all about the beauty of life. Thank you for bringing us hope in such a challenging time. Words cannot describe how grateful we are for your existence. Papa and I love you to the moon and back, and I promise you that I will protect you and look after you until my last breath. Your proud mama.